Hi everyone. So we have gone through a lot of different terms, right? Babel, Webpack, NPM. So what we will do in this video, we will just have a quick recap around all these terms which we have gone through. So I think this diagram will give you a little bit clarity. What we have is we are writing ES6 and then we are writing React, and what we are using is Babel and Webpack to compile this code and making the final ES5 code which our browser can read, right? So what we are writing for this, we are including the Babel and Webpack dependencies, and we are writing Webpack config file, and then we are adding some npm script to build the React component and start the Webpack server if you want to see how the component look like. Okay, so here we have done the basic setup, right? Now you can extend this code to any further. You can write any complex application here. You keep adding the modules here. Like I have a cart component, I have a product component, all these things you can keep adding. Cart, product, right? And you can just have one single component as a root component that you can use just to display the output of the whole application. Okay, so just talk about these terms. JSX is HTML JS-like code. ES6 is ECMAS 6, which has some new features in JavaScript. Now we are seeing a lot of new trends in ES6, ES7, ES8. We are just using the Babel configurations to compile that latest version of JavaScript code into ES5. So those are called as a Babel presets. Babel preset stage 1, stage 2, stage 3. Those dependencies you can add just to compile your latest JavaScript code. Okay. React.js as a framework. So I'm just going through my Git book, which has all the things covered basically. So we talked about three basic principles about React. React uses virtual DOM. It is providing the one-way data flow. And React talks only about Vue, right? So all these framework, we see React, Angular, Ember, jQuery, and all these are which are dealing with the client side JavaScript, deals with the DOM, right? So because what we end up doing is DOM manipulation. If I wanted to show change on the UI on the button click, I will be updating the DOM. Either it is being done by React, Angular, jQuery, or I will be writing the vanilla JavaScript code to do that using document.query, element by ID, and then query selector. All these code I will be writing. Okay, so this virtual DOM is actually in-memory DOM we are having, and that in-memory DOM actually represents what currently we have, right? So whenever some change is actually happening, that change will first happen on the virtual DOM which we have in the memory, and then once it applies, how it applies is it actually keeps comparing itself with the actual DOM which we see on the UI, and whenever you click on button, some component changes, some component getting re-rendered, then it is applying that change to the actual DOM in very optimal way. That is the difference between other framework and React. Okay, so we can divide the whole application into multiple component like this. It can be like this search field can be a separate component. These product list can be another component, something like this. Okay, and how we are writing the component. I'm not covering ES5 at all here, but you can write React component in ES5 also, something like this. I used to teach something like this in the ES5. You can use react.create class, which is helping you to create your component directly in the ES5. And if you just convert this code, now if you're writing code in ES5, then you don't need a transpiler of ES6 to ES5. What you need is you need only this JSX transpiler, because this piece only browser can't understand. Okay, what is JSX and how it is getting compiled? We have already seen this in the Babel. It is getting converted into react.create element. It has three arguments: tag name, attribute, and the children. Okay. You can create a parent component, child component, how they are rendering is. Let's see this example and try to understand it. Now, in our application, it's not like we are going to have only one component. We will have parent component, child component, and all. So consider that I have a username component, okay, and this is my hello component, because hello component only I'm mounting. React DOM.render, hello component, and this is the user. I will talk about this, don't get confused what I'm doing. So here I have two components, hello component and user component. In real life application also you will have a different components, product list item, cart component, shared component and all these things. But how these components talk to each other, how the data passing is happening, how the change is being shown on the UI whenever you are adding item to the cart, removing item to the cart, because something is changing in the components, and whenever something is changing we are actually acting on the UI and rendering the UI back, right? That we will see how React components react whenever there is a change in the data in the components. Okay, React loves ES6. We are writing the class-based component and we are using Babel as a transpiler and Webpack as a bundler. Setting up React component we have done. We are using the basic application. We have set up the npm. You can start create application basically using npm init, and we have installed React using npm install -- save React, React DOM. React library is helping us to create a component. React DOM library is helping us to mount the component on the DOM node. This is how we are creating package.json. Okay, and here we created our first hello world component, something like this, right? This we have already seen how this component look like. We are creating React, we imported React and React DOM. We created a component, so this component should extend react.component, otherwise it is just a ES6 class, not a component. And then we are mounting that component onto the root node, right? So we created a component, we are mounting that component to some DOM node, so that is a rendering phase. And this is available here if you just wanted to look at it. In React, everything is a component. So whatever we are writing is component. We will be end up, so this diagram, you see, you will understand it. When we are building an application, like this is the messenger application. It will have a navbar component, message component, message attachment component, mail list item component. So everything is one or another way represents some UI component. They are responsible to show something on the UI. They will deal with some data which they are receiving. They will show some data, and whenever the data is getting changed, they will update the UI. So now everything will be our focus on the components, how they behave when data is getting changed, how they are getting data from the parent component, how the data passing is happening from the parent to child, how the data, how they react when something had changed on the UI, like you are sending a new message. So new message should pop up like WhatsApp or Facebook Messenger, right? When new friend is getting added in the list. So some visible changes are keep happening on the UI, right? So how that is happening, so that we will see. We will just draw these whole components and we'll see what they are going to have. Okay, after this we are going to cover create React app. So after this I will just have one small video where I will just do a quick recap on the components, how you can actually use Webpack only to write your production level application, not end to end, but you can write enough components to have that. Then we will move to create React app, because the thing is developers are not getting friendly with Webpack and Babel, so they can just directly use create React app. It's a CLI interface, you don't need to understand any configuration. You can just write hello world application and keep extending your application.